Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
And good morning, everybody. It is that time again and time of the week. It is Tiger Talk. You're listening to it live on Thursday, May 9th, 8:02 a.m. if you're riding in your car. I'm your host, Kevin Daly, and with my beautiful co-host, yes. Mrs. Yes.
Yes,
I am beautiful.
No, but I am your co-host. Yeah.
I thought you were saying, yes, I am beautiful. No. You are beautiful.
Oh, well, thank you.
You know, as in a friend kind of way.
And
sorry, Mr. Definitely. Groom.
This
is Tiger Talk, run by the kids for the kids. So we have some kids in the studio. We'll talk about them later. They do the video and the sound. They're prepping for their new next career to hopefully be in some kind of their own show, studio, TV. They're doing a nice little field trip tomorrow to 22 News. So
ooh,
that's gonna be
nice.
Cool. So we can. They're
oh,
actually
it's
coming
today.
On today. It's today, not tomorrow. But the good news is we're gonna have some. Okay. Some radio kids and Mr. Forney on later on in the show. I didn't want a spoiler alert, but they're going to come on later and talk about some things that they've been doing. So that's exciting.
It'll be exciting because I don't even know what's happening.
It's exciting because, because you didn't meet to go to the producers meeting.
Right.
Yeah. The co-hosts don't.
I think I wasn't invited.
No,
but that's okay.
We invite the important people, so I'm sorry you didn't get the memo. But next time.
You are not sorry.
So anyway, we had a good show last week. We had a great show. So if you haven't caught Tiger Talk, we had a two-week hiatus. We're back and better than ever. But last week was a fantastic show. We had our Skills USA kids on.
Yep.
Adriana Vasquez and Brady LePage, two of our students, have qualified to go on to the national competition.
I know, that's so great.
In where?
Atlanta, Georgia.
In I don't know exactly the date. It's in the summer. Is it July?
Yeah, I believe it's when it's going to be the
TBD,
hottest.
TBD. Hot time, hot Atlanta, they call it, and they're going to be down there for it. So we have two. Adriana's going to be in Collision Tech trying to win the competition down there in those. And Brady's doing a internet, like home internet.
I don't know
thing.
The details, but yeah, he does that. That's great.
But if you want, that's a great show. Last week, catch it up there. It should be on YouTube.
I don't
maybe.
Know if it's been posted yet.
It will be on YouTube soon.
Yes.
WSKB Radio on YouTube and check it out. It's a fantastic show.
Mm-hmm.
Today we have, before we get to our guests, we have the restaurant open today.
We do.
You want to tell us what's on tap for the restaurant at Tiger's Pride, run by the kids?
It was fantastic yesterday.
Yes, it was. I had a beautiful chicken Is it francais?
It depends.
Or francais? Because I don't like you, the people that say francais. I think it's a francais.
It's francais, because you say in French, francais.
Not francese?
No, but in other languages, they might. I think in Italian, it's francese.
Mm.
So I like.
You know what a language
francais.
I speak in? English.
yeah.
Francais.
Sure.
Yes.
So that was a delicious dish.
It was
yesterday.
Good.
So the soups this week, cream of asparagus and borscht. And then the salad of the week is a classic chef's salad with greens, assorted garden vegetables, ham, turkey, Swiss, and cheddar cheeses, and boiled egg. Entree today, listen up, Mr. Daly.
Yeah, I am because I
fried
didn't bring a lunch.
Fried calamari.
Oh, I can't have that.
Lightly floured fried calamari tossed with garlic, tomato, and banana peppers, served with marinara sauce. I guarantee I will see that at lunch today.
Maybe
not
I'll get
for
one.
Me.
Maybe I'll get one for the whole table. Sure.
Yeah, I'm sure. And then homestyle meatloaf served with garlic mashed
Mr.
potatoes,
Hastings.
Asparagus, and pan gravy.
Uh-huh.
And the sandwich of the week is a turkey Rachel croissant melt, sliced turkey coleslaw, Thousand Island dressing, and Swiss cheese melted on a flaky croissant.
You know what I think every time I hear Rachel?
I know what you think.
What?
Friends.
Yes.
And that's because that's her favorite, I believe.
Oh, it is?
That kind of sandwich. I believe so.
She's
I've seen
my
it
favorite.
On other... Yes. As I knew that.
Except,
that's why I said Rachel,
wife, of
course.
Yeah.
Mrs. Daly.
Yeah.
The tomorrow's entrees.
Yeah, open tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow too, 10:45, 12:15. Creamy garlic and mushroom pasta.
Mm.
Sauteed mushrooms with garlic, spinach, sun-dried tomatoes, cream, white wine, and Parmesan cheese tossed with penne pasta. And that's served with a petite salad.
Mm.
And then fish and chips, beer-battered Atlantic pollock filet served with French fries. There's your French fries. Ketchup, coleslaw, and tartar sauce.
I'm not putting that in my this temple. I can't eat French fries. You want me to eat calamari and French fries? I'm on a mission.
That's exactly what you like to eat.
Yes. Well, I'm not going to. I'm on a mission right now. Summer body right now.
OK.
I'm 50 now. I got to take care of this thing.
Yep.
Yeah. So if you're interested, the restaurant is open to all public right now, 10:45 to 12:15. Mm-hmm. Please swing by. We had a decent crowd yesterday, yep. but we have it's no need to call for reservations. It's wide open. And what you're doing is you're giving the kids perfect practice.
Right. And you can't beat the prices. And I ran into somebody I know, a former guidance counselor, yeah. and she said it was the best chicken francais she's ever had.
I thought it was fantastic.
So, and I brought it home to Bill.
Yeah. Did he like it?
He loved it.
Yeah. And if you're going, listen, I think about it this way. If you have the opportunity to go out to lunch and at a restaurant around mm-hmm. town, not that we don't want to support a business in town, but why not come
but
here?
But we're not open every day.
No.
So, when we are open, take advantage of the gem over here on 33 Smith Avenue.
So that's awesome. So we're looking forward to an awesome week of culinary deliciousness.
Yeah, 3 days. This is great. Yep.
Yeah.
The staff is very happy.
What else is going on, Mrs. Groom, around town?
Well, we just had our plant sale.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that.
So I know. I just want to make mention of it. Yeah. Why can't I just say that?
I didn't say anything. I said,
No, you gave me dagger eyes.
Yeah, now you know what it's like. plant sale's going on. We're going to have Mr. Sperry and some kids on to talk about that any minute. What else we got?
I don't even know what to mention because I don't want to get the eyes again. The motorsports is coming up May 18th. We've got the prom coming up Friday.
Yes, the prom. Record numbers of the prom at the Crestview Country Club. So parents, if there is some weird case where you have to get, I got to get out early to get my hair done because I'm going. But you got to go a half day of school. Mm-hmm. Mandatory, or you're not eligible to go to school, go to the prom.
That's always an issue.
Don't bombard everybody with phone calls because everybody's getting out. Go to the full day of school and go to the prom tonight. So we're looking forward to it. How's the weather looking for tomorrow night?
I'm not a weather girl. I have no idea. Mm-hmm.
Hopefully it's good. I feel like it's going to be like this. But it'll be a great time. We have record numbers for the prom. We're sold out.
Yes.
At Crestview Country Club. So I'm looking forward to that. It's always a good night. And over the past few years, it's like we keep raising the bar. More and more kids are going. I think we're getting back to good.
Yes, that's the thing. We're getting out of that old,
Don't say it.
No, I'm not saying it. But also coming up Tuesday and Wednesday, May 21st and 22nd, grade 10 MCAS math.
Oh.
That means 3-hour delay for everybody else.
Oh, 3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Okay.
The math is a tough one.
And that is a tough one. And they got to pass it.
Yeah,
And finally, but not least, we have big news here. We are darn close to finishing all the applications and acceptance letters for all the kids for next year. So we had 219. Applications for the school. So that is over the past few years, that seems to be our magic number. Mm-hmm. We seem to be getting if we get over 200 applications, back in the day, I've been here 12 years now, we would get 160, 170. Okay. Now we're over 220, which is, kudos to the school and all the instructors and all the publicity we've been getting, and the word is out. We're not a secret anymore. No. So we are the best tech school in Westfield, and I would argue we're the best tech school around.
I think so. I agree. So
the applications are good. I know there's going to be some super excited kids coming up pretty soon, and I know there's going to be a couple disappointed kids. So goes life.
That is it.
Yeah. That's it. What we're going to do right now is, Sophia, why don't we get a quick commercial break while we bring in our horticulture kids, and then we're going to talk real quick about the plant sale and all that Mr. Sperry's been doing, and maybe we'll get a little bee talk, too.
Okay, sounds good.
We'll be back.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield. Underwriting for Community Radio on WSKB is brought to you in part by Rockies. Over 30 convenient locations throughout Massachusetts, Rhode Island, New Hampshire, Connecticut, and Florida. One of the nation's largest Ace dealers. Expertise and great product selection in paint, hardware, lawn and garden. That's Rockies, rock solid service since 1926. On the web at rockies.com. Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Barnes and Noble College Bookstore in the Ely Campus Center, offering Westfield State t-shirts, sweatshirts, and gift merchandise.
all of your academic needs, and offering textbook materials in new, used, ebook, and rental formats. Available at the bookstore on campus or online at westfieldstate.bncollege.com.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 at 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
Yeah, we are back, everybody. You're listening to Tiger Talk Live on May 9, 2024. It's 8:12 if you're listening to the car. No, it's not music. It's us. It's Tiger Talk, the number one show on WSKB Radio, self-proclaimed. I'm not sure if we are, but we would be if we could get our show posted. So let's just leave it at that. So there's been a lot of feedback. I've gotten a lot of calls to the office, like, where is Tiger Talk? How come we can't watch it? We're working on it. Some technical glitches. We're working on it. And Mrs. Groom?
No, that's not me. To go to YouTube, I don't have access to that.
I was just going to say, and Mrs. Groom, who looks wonderful today, is upset.
Am so, I? Oh, yeah. Okay. All right.
Yeah. We are joined by a full crew here today. Mr. Sperry, no stranger to the show. He's our horticulture teacher, bee extraordinaire. And we will talk a little bee talk, huh?
Oh, sure. Why not?
It's honey time.
I love talking about bees.
Yeah. So he's our national, the Massachusetts National Beekeeper Award winner for the world. Mm-hmm. Across the
galaxy.
Galaxy.
Yeah.
I didn't think you were going to get it for Australia, but you got it.
I did.
Congratulations.
And Jupiter and the rest of the galaxy.
So we are joined by some students here because we want to talk about one of the most amazing things we do years, particularly obviously for you guys, but for the whole school. It's called the plant sale.
Right.
It's a big time name, but it's big time deals and big time community event. Mr. Sperry, tell us about that. How long have you been doing that? It's probably since before you got here, right?
Yeah.
Tell us about the plant sale, what it is, what do we have to offer, and then we'll get some kids involved.
So some people might remember Mark Stewart, who taught here, started the program back in the 90s. And then when the original greenhouse was built with the program, he started a plant sale, and that's just continued to grow every year. When I came here in 2008, I think I started at Westfield Tech, basically just continue to expand it. And so now we have multiple greenhouses. The students do a great job. Our plant sale begins basically right when January rolls around. We start to fill up all the pots, all the hanging baskets, all the smaller pots that people buy. And then the plants come as plugs from Canada. And so they're obviously just really small rooted cuttings. And they plant all those, and then we grow them out. So the students fertilize them, water, take care of them, do a bunch of different things to them throughout the February, March, April months. And then come May for the plant sale, they're ready to go. And we sell them to the community. And so, number one, the kids do a great job. And then number two, the community does a great job at supporting the plant sale because it's just turned into – when COVID happened, we had a whole greenhouse or multiple greenhouses full of plants that I wasn't sure that we were going to be able to sell. And we got approval to sell those in the greenhouse. We had to sell them in the greenhouse because COVID doesn't spread in the greenhouse, but it did in school.
That's right.
And so
the plants eat up the COVID.
Right. So so we did that, and I'll never forget that day because I wasn't sure how many people we would – see that day, if people would stay away. And I remember I was helping someone in the greenhouse select a hanging basket or whatever, and then I walked outside and I saw a line of people all the way down Greylock Street. And actually I got a little emotional because I just couldn't believe how many people from the community came out to support us that day. And since then it's been like a, I think people think it's a one-day event because everyone comes on Tuesday.
Yeah.
But let it be known that we still have some plants available. We have lots of vegetables. We have some potted plants. We have a few hangers left. And we have some perennials left, too. So it's on Facebook this morning, all the Westfield community pages.
Yeah.
And people can come on down and still get some plants today till 2 or 8 to 2 tomorrow tomorrow Friday.
I love it. Who do we got here joining us, Mr. Sperry?
We have Brooke.
Last names, too.
Brooke Emmelman.
Yes.
We have Allie or
Lily.
Lily, sorry, not my student.
Yeah, I don't know why she's here. Lily Boucher is here, but she's a helper, I guess. Apparently, yeah.
And we have Usab, and we have Jay Ellinger.
Yes. So,
and Usab, you have to help me with your last names.
Groom.
Okay. Usab Grung. Hey, yeah. Speak up. Get into that mic, Usab. Grung. Yeah. Hey, stay here, Usab. Usab's the first time on the show, right, Usab? Come on. Get, you got to eat the mic when you're talking.
I am.
Hey, thanks for coming on. Tell us, what have you been doing, Usab, with the plant sale? What are some of the things you were responsible for? You can even go back to when it was December. Like, what are some of the things you were involved with the plant sale?
Mostly, like, getting plants out of the greenhouse into the shop, organizing some of them. And then back in December, it wasn't much greenhouses. It was mostly outdoors.
Yep.
But, like, when it came near the plants, there, mostly it was greenhouse work, deadheading, and all those.
Yeah, what's deadheading?
You want prune the plants when you take the flowers off so new flowers can grow.
Okay, and that's done every time it flowers, we do that? Is that common practice among green thumb people that we should do that every time there's a flower?
No.
Well, yeah, it's just the plants don't look as good if they've got spent flower buds on them. So we do our best to deadhead all the plants as they're selling, but on Tuesday they sell so fast that it's just really difficult to
keep. You know, Mr. Hastings is a deadhead.
Mr. Hastings is a deadhead.
Yeah.
I've tried to introduce him to other similar music in the genre, but so far I don't know if I've been successful with that.
Usab, what is one of your favorite things to do when you're in horticulture? I know it's not just greenhousing. I mean, we do a lot of stuff.
And mostly hardscaping.
You like hardscaping. What is hardscaping? What is that?
Basically, I don't know how to put it in the description, but basically it's like building patios, working with, instead of working on plant identification or regular landscaping, like such as mowing lawns, like freelance, basically.
Yeah.
But in hardscaping, you're building stuff, then doing regular landscaping.
That's a lot of hard work, isn't it? A little manual labor?
It is, but
you don't mind it.
It's fun. Like, it's something to do, you know?
Yeah.
Rather than be bored all day.
Yeah. We don't want to be bored.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. And I think that when you guys do a wall or a patio or a pergola, whatever it is, you guys do amazing work. It's very rewarding at the end, right, to see what you guys have accomplished. Ma'am. Hey, let's talk to you. What do you like doing the best?
I enjoy the hardscaping.
You do?
But I also enjoy the planting as well.
Yeah.
I like the art that comes along with it, the designing the property before you go out and do the work.
Yeah. What year are you?
I'm a junior.
They're all juniors.
Come on, closer. Tell me about the plant sale. What have you been doing during the week for a plant sale?
So we were all assigned a section to take care of, and you just get to know those plants and answer any questions that you're asked, and you continue to bring more plants up and fill it in.
Yeah. What do you think? How has it been? Anybody can answer this. How has the turnout been? I know we're in day three of the sale. I guess you were here last year, right? So you know what.
I think it's really good. Last year, It wasn't as slow as it is now. There was a lot of people on Tuesday, and we sold most of it last year.
Yeah.
This year we sold about half of it on Tuesday.
Yeah. Brooke, there was a situation on day one in the greenhouse. Tell us about that and how did you fix it? Because Mr. Sperry said you were the mastermind behind taking care of the issue.
So we had this huge rack with plants on it that fell backwards.
Yes.
With all the plants on
yes.
it. So we had to take all the plants off.
Did we have any wounded plants, or did we save them?
No, they were all okay.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But we had to take all the pipes apart and bend them back together because they were wonky. Then we had to put it all back together.
And you had some collaboration with other shops, which I'm sure this is why Lily's on. Lily, what did you do to... because I'm sure that's why you're on the show today to talk about how construction...
Actually, that's not why she's here. She's been with us all week.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Roy is kind of... pawned her off on us, and we've been more than happy to have Lily with us. She's been awesome, providing everything from customer service to just helping with every aspect of the sale, and so she's like an honorary horticulture student for this week, and I mean, I'm assuming just to the end of the year at this point.
Yeah. We will say this, we, and obviously, if you guys could be there on the first day, how busy it is, all hands on deck, basically. There's a lot of customers coming from the public. There's different ages of the customers. Some are elderly that need help, that look forward to this big event. Anybody that can help, we actually had Ms. Markowski come down and help out. We were able to fortunately have her come down and
that
do that.
Great.
And Miss Ham came back, who was a former employee here.
I didn't know that.
And 2 days. She came Monday and Tuesday. Yeah. Yep.
Nice.
And Lily, obviously, your help is, you know, thank you for helping out.
Cross-collaboration.
Yeah, for the collaboration and with construction. And construction's sort of on a, not a lull, but a little. They were busy with the house,
Finished the house. They're done.
Yep. So now they're working on the project at Babe Ruth. They're fixing the press box up there, and they were able to spare Lily for this week to help out with the horticulture. So we appreciate that.
Horticulture helped us. We have to give it back.
Yes, that's it. That's
good
it.
Good way we're to look
team.
At it.
Tell us how much we have today and tomorrow, Mr. Sperry.
Right.
What else is on tap for horticulture to throughout the year with these guys?
Yeah, so we're working on a project on Lindbergh. We are doing a walkway, fire pit, patio. We're doing a Goshen stone walkway too.
Wow.
So I haven't done a Goshen stone walkway with students yet.
I've done
some Goshen stone walls, but Goshen stone is a naturally occurring stone that we get up in the Berkshires. It's a schist. It's a sedimentary rock.
Watch your mouth.
That is easy. It's relatively easy to work with a hammer, so you can shape the stone. So it requires more skill than just simply like concrete pavers that are made to a certain, you know, standard size. These we actually fit together one at a time, and it's time consuming. It's like a big jigsaw puzzle with stone.
Working with crazy shifts.
Mm-hmm. But when we're done, I think it's going to look great, and then we'll do a big planting there as well, and that will probably take us about to the end of the school year. That's a pretty big job.
Yeah.
So,
if there's any work that anybody listening wants to get done, how is that? Do they just call you, email you, and then obviously you? How far in advance do they need to call you to plan? That sounds like a pretty big job.
Yeah. So, I mean, we've had a lot of these types of requests at the plant sale. People pull me aside and say, "Hey, how can I get you to come to our property?" Of course, we'd love to get to everyone, but there's just no way I can do that. I mean, I probably get. It seems like I get 10 requests a day via email.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Everything from, you know, can you do a leaf cleanup to can you do this larger construction project? So obviously I like to take the larger projects on. I think there's just more educational value for the students
sure.
in those types of projects. But that said, you know, we can only get to so many of those a year, maybe 3 or 4, and I get a lot of requests.
Yeah.
But people can always email us. You know, my email is n.sperry@schoolsofwestfield.org, and they can send me an email. Sometimes I don't get back to everybody just because of the number of requests that we have. But if a certain project piques my interest, then, you know, we'll take a look at it and see if we can get you on a list.
Yeah, I think that horticulture is one of the most popular shops where people want work done by them, and that what they don't realize sometimes is that they're on a week on, week off schedule, and some kids you can do crazy complicated projects with, and then the next week we can't. So, and then you're playing with the weather.
Then in the fall it's, you know, exploratory, so we're only able to go out every other week, really,
so,
realistically. So it's not easy to.
But if you are lucky enough to get them to pick a job for you, you're gonna be so
great
pleased,
yes.
You know, because they do professional work and they're. They do great jobs, and Mr. Sperry, good job with those guys. And we're going to roll because we got other things going on. But how is the bee season going on right now? Is it honey time? What's happening?
It's honey time, yeah. If
you guys see bees, leave them alone, please. Right, tell me, what's going on?
So May, June are traditionally our big honey production months. I mean, everyone, if you're driving your car right now, you probably look around, you see all kinds of trees in flower, plants in flower, and, of course, our honeybee population takes advantage of that by collecting nectar and pollen, and they bring that nectar back to the hive and make honey with it. So right now, beekeepers put on boxes that we call honey supers. We put those on our hives to try to collect the surplus honey that the bees make. So I was out past few days finishing
that up.
I'm
sure busy time for you.
Yeah, it's a busy time.
And we have our beehive up on upper campus.
Right.
Is that thriving right now?
They are thriving, yeah. All three made it through the winter.
Yep.
And they're doing very, very well. So.
Okay, I have one question.
I also have a question, but
okay. Well, I'm worried about that one. But I have many crab apple trees that are flowering right now. It's beautiful. And I thought I was, do you remember the movie The Swarm? It was like the 70s or 80s. Remember that?
I do.
And the bees are coming, and they're so loud. And I had this constant buzz coming from the trees. And I was like, holy moly.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked up, but they were like bumblebees. They weren't like small honeybees. Now, bumblebees are taking honey.
Oh, yeah.
They all do it?
Yeah, bumblebees don't make honey, but they're a very good pollinator.
Yeah.
So they actually pollinate through vibration. They'll vibrate the flower and get the pollen grains to fall out. So like
I almost fell down. They're vibrating the ground so much.
If anyone knows what a blueberry bush in flower looks like, it's like a bell-shaped flower, mm-hmm. and the honeybees can't really quite reach inside to pollinate those. What they do is they chew in the side of the flower, and they access the pollen that way, so it's a lot more work for them.
Right.
A bumblebee will just sit on the flower itself and vibrate and then grab the
falls
pollen
out.
That way. Yep. Yeah, so they're efficient pollinators.
That was a good question.
That was a great question.
Was it? That was like, and now I actually learned something. That was pretty good.
You did, yes.
Right? Did you know that, Brooke? You didn't. Okay. Question for Mr. Sperry. Usab, you're next if you want one. Go ahead.
All right, so the plant sale is scheduled around Mother's Day, mm-hmm. right? And we have Mother's Day coming up on Sunday.
Yes.
So I'm driving to work this morning, and this is just more of like, you know, conversation.
Yes. Okay.
Maybe a poll. Too bad we don't take callers.
We do.
It could be a good call-in
question. We can do a poll.
Facebook poll.
So I'm driving to work, coming down Route 20, and I get a text from my daughter, don't forget Sunday's Mother's Day. You have to take mom out to dinner.
Yeah.
And I thought to myself, oh, man, that's right. I'd have to do mm-hmm. that. Then a few minutes went by, and I said, wait a minute. Why do I have to do that?
That's not your mother.
She's not my mother.
Right.
So what's the group think here? What's my obligation?
You go out as a family.
You do it as a family.
Yep.
And Mr. Sperry is responsible for taking care of his kid's mother.
All of you.
It's
a team effort.
It's a team effort.
It is?
Yeah.
So okay. Has she ever...
She makes you sandwiches for lunch.
Yep.
That's
good
true.
Point. She does some motherly
182
duties.
182 of them a year, ham and cheese sandwiches.
Yeah.
So who's paying for it, though?
You.
Mother's Day.
You guys can split it.
Well, do your kids have an income?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I guess it depends on how old your kids are.
They have an income.
See, I'm with Mr. Sperry on this. I sent a text to my kids saying, hey, by the way, it's Mother's Day Sunday. Let me know if you need any help with anything.
Oh, boy.
Crickets. Yeah. Chirp, chirp, chirp.
The expectation is...
Usab.
But you also wouldn't have a family with that.
Usab, you're the last word for horticulture. Give us your input. What do you think?
What do I think on?
Who's is it up to Mr. Sperry to buy his wife a Mother's Day gift?
No, it's not up to Mr. Sperry. It's up to the kids. Like basically,
fantastic.
I agree with Mr. Sperry on that. It's going to be up to the kids rather than
smart guy right there.
Hammered it, Usab. Guys, listen. Thank you for coming on. Great job with the plant sale. Lily, thank you for helping out the horticulture. Mr. Sperry, great job as always. Everybody, still catch that plant sale till tomorrow, 8 to 2.
8 to 2 tomorrow, yeah. The flyer that's posted says 8 to 5, but we're going to be closing it down at 2 o'clock
on Friday. End of the week discounts?
To be determined.
Mr. Sperry, do you have to get ready for prom?
To be determined.
And the prom is tomorrow. So
no, I'm not going to prom.
I know.
I am.
Stunningly not invited.
I invited
you multiple times.
Tiger Talk here live. Let's go to our first song. Thanks, everybody. We'll be back.
7A.
What number is this, Chip?
7A.
Okay, no, I mean, like, don't get excited, man. It's because I'm short, I know.
Oh, I could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. My shaven razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? You once thought of me as a white knight on his steed. Now you know how happy I can be. Starts and ends without dollar one to spend. But how much, baby, do I really need? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer?
Support for community radio on WSKB provided by Westfield Electroplating. Employing over 140 skilled platers, painters, and technicians, Westfield Electroplating was founded in 1946 and was the first company in the country to achieve National Aerospace and Defense Contractor Program accreditation, proudly maintaining that status for over a decade. Westfield Electroplating provides over 50 quality finishes to meet your corrosion, cosmetic, or performance needs. On the web at www.westfieldplating.com or 413-568-3716. Westfield Electroplating, putting the finishing touches on technology.
Underwriting support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Greater Westfield Chamber of Commerce, the voice of business for the Greater Westfield communities. Informing, educating, advocating, the Chamber provides opportunities for members to make meaningful connections on local, regional, and state levels. For more information on the Chamber's many events, workshops, and programs, as well as the benefits of membership, visit westfieldbiz.org. The Chamber focuses on the most important economy, yours.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 at 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
And you're back to Tiger Talk Live. It's May 9th. It's 8:34 a.m. I'm back with my beautiful co-host, Carol Groom, here leading us back. We just had a great segment on the horticulture and the plant sale. If you missed it, just tune back in. YouTube.
Yeah, hopefully that gets posted.
Yep. WSKB Radio, 89.5. You're listening live, run by the kids, for the kids. Interesting little tidbit. Did you know that Bumblebee? Did you know that?
Well, I just learned that. I didn't know that.
I thought I was getting... Nobody got my swarm. Do you remember the movie,
yes,
The Swarm?
Of course I do.
They were coming and they took over the United States and they were on the news like, watch out, here comes the swarm.
Maybe Jimmy Stewart was in that.
I don't know who that is. Oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Every time a bell rings...
He did get older after that movie.
So what you have next coming on is our motorsports club, and representative from motorsports club. And we got the reason we're having him on is because we have a we'll go two and two there, guys. We are have a big car show coming up, not this weekend, but the next weekend after that, May 18th. 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. But we also wanted to bring them on to talk about that. And also, we had a nice little donation we wanted to talk about. And also, we wanted to bring on our favorite auto tech teacher I can say it. Okay, who is who's parting ways with us a little bit. So we want to honor him a little bit, you know.
We do.
And it's going to be sad to see him go.
But we're happy for him because he's doing good things.
Yeah, he's doing good things. We'll talk about that a little bit, but I wasn't sure if everybody knew Mr. Rainey, so I didn't want to have the kids be like, "What?"
We're good.
Yeah, so we'll talk about that. But let's talk about the car show first. Maddie, hi, Maddie.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
Do you know everybody that's in here right now? You want to introduce everybody that's from the auto tech community? So, who we got with us?
Dan.
Yep.
We got Nick.
Yep.
And we got me.
Yeah. And last but not least,
Mr. Rainey.
Mr. Rainey. Dan, you can slide up to that microphone if you want. And when you guys are talking, just make sure you talk close to it. Mr. Rainey, tell us about the car show. How long have we been doing it? Where is it this year? What's going on?
So this year is going to be our fifth year doing the car show. So it's our fifth annual car show. This year we are doing it with Grandmother's Garden.
Nice.
So we did have people reach out. It's their 90th anniversary, and they wanted to host a car show this year. So we'll be having it across the street on the lawn. So we're looking forward to that. I think that's going to give us a chance to maybe in the future to expand and give us more room for cars.
Yeah, if you're not familiar, Smith Ave is typically where we've had the show before, the parking lot. It's it's a tough entrance a little bit. It's sort of beat up a little bit in the parking lot. Lower cars have trouble doing it. Mm-hmm. And we're partnering up with Grandmother's Garden this year. Did you know it was called Chauncey Allen Park?
I do, yeah.
Yeah, I never knew that.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, so I'm a townie.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I didn't know that. So we're looking forward to that. But do we have people signing up to bring cars in, Mr. Rainey? How does that work?
So it's May 18th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Usually it's fine if you want to show up a little early, 9, 9:30, if you want to get a good spot and not have to worry about waiting in line to get in. We don't have any pre-registration or anything like that, so it's just first come, first serve.
Is there a fee required to bring your car in or a donation, or what's up with that?
Yeah, we ask for a $10 donation to park your car in the show. Spectators are free.
Yeah, and obviously that money goes back to the school a little bit, right? And
yes.
Dan, have you worked the car show in the past?
No, it's going to be my first time.
Your first time, right? Maddie, have you?
Yeah.
What did you do at the car show? What's one of the things?
I worked registration, checking cars in.
Yeah, go ahead. Keep going.
And then we did raffles. Yeah, raffles, and
yeah. Nick, does anybody, how do we do once the car show gets going? Do we group the cars separately? Like if you have like a really cool 67 Scout, like does that get its own category or... Mustangs go in a certain spot, or what happens there? How do we set the cars up?
The 2 years that I've done it so far, we did it differently. But last year we had it where we set it up by a year and country of origin. Mm-hmm. So we had like up to 80s, I think it was U.S., and then we had imports, and then we had a truck section.
So any vehicle you got, if you are proud of it and want to bring it, doesn't matter. 2024 up to, you know, back to 1920s old school cars.
Whatever. Yeah.
And is there a competition for best scout or anything like that, Maddie?
Not for your scout.
Okay. Yeah.
Mr. Daly, we get it. You have a scout.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Okay. It may or may not make the show. I want to talk about Mr. Rainey, a 2024 vehicle. Tell us about the newest car. We had an awesome thing happen to us last couple weeks ago, maybe now. What was that all about?
So a couple of weeks ago, we had Sarah Ford donate a brand new 2024 Mustang GT to our program.
There it is on the screen if you're looking.
Yeah. There it is.
Ridiculously nice. Yeah.
So this was in conjunction with, we work with Ford itself, and they offer us their Ford ACE program, which allows the students to have access to factory training by Ford. We've been doing that for a few years now, and we've been in the works of hopefully getting a donated vehicle. And luckily, it just took a flood in Michigan to make that happen. Yeah. So the vehicle it wasn't a flood, so they can't sell it. They had to decommission a whole bunch of vehicles that were in that flood. There was barely any water that actually made it in it, I think. There's nothing wrong with the vehicle.
Yeah, I actually got in it, and it looks like a brand new car.
There's 110 miles on it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's awesome.
It's amazing. So thank you to Sarah Ford for doing that, obviously.
Absolutely, yep.
Did we know we were getting a Mustang, or was it could have been anything, right? Or how did we...
We knew it was a Mustang.
Yeah.
We kind of knew in the beginning of the school year. It just took a while to actually get it here. Mm-hmm. So it's a lot better than Ford Focus, that's for sure.
Exactly.
Oh, for sure.
Mr. Rainey, what is the benefit now of having a 2024 vehicle in the shop?
So having a newer vehicle like that opens up the door to a whole bunch of modern technology. Mm-hmm. You know, we can introduce advanced diagnostics. We can plug in scan tools and see the modern capabilities of vehicles with lane assist and all kinds of things in regards to that. New refrigerant systems because, you know, there's a new refrigerant out there. We have the machine for it. We don't really work on vehicles that are new enough to have that. So
yeah, typically a brand new car is going to the dealership for the first few years anyway, right? Before they start hitting a regular regular garage. I would say, I just sat in the thing for a couple minutes, that is every bell and whistle possible that you could. Is that top of the line kind of Mustang? I mean, it's pretty close?
It's close to it, yeah.
It sounds pretty cool. Dan, have you seen the Mustang?
Yeah, I saw it.
Have you heard it?
Yeah, it sounds nice.
Dan, tell us about Motorsports Club. Are you part of Motorsports Club?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what does that do? I know. What do you guys do at Motorsports Club? How often do you guys meet, and what is it all about?
We meet every Wednesday.
Yep.
And we try to build the kit car.
The kit car. And we're working on that. We've been working on a kit car, Mr. Rainey, for a couple years now.
Yeah, 2-3 years.
And typically after school, what days do you guys meet after school?
Wednesdays.
I'll go, Maddie. Wednesdays. And every Wednesday open to only auto tech kids? How does that work?
No, it's open to every shop, any kid who wants to turn a wrench or do anything like that on the kit car.
Yeah. So this kit car we purchased a couple years ago. We've slowly been surely making progress on it. The Motorsports Club, if you have time, depending on the kids you get, it will determine what you work on. Correct, Mr. Ray? That's how it goes?
Yeah.
Yeah. Maddie, is there a scheduled date to have this thing done?
No.
No.
We're hoping that we can get it to the car show for this year. That's the goal.
Yeah. So right now we have it as a roller. Mm-hmm. So the suspension's on it. The wheels are on it. Mm-hmm. Steering wheel's on it. So you can steer it. You can push it. We're trying to get a seat in it and brakes so we can at least tie it up and
drag it. Drag it
up to the car show.
Nice. Looking forward to that. Nick, you've been a long. You're what year? Are you junior now?
I'm a junior and I started motorsport basically from the beginning. As soon as I heard about it, I was in it.
Yeah. What do you like best about Auto Tech and the Motorsports Club?
I've just always really liked and have been into cars and the mechanics, and then and the mechanic aspect of it, working on cars, getting under the hood, looking at different things, and being able to make my own car with my friends is amazing.
Yeah, and you are a celebrity because you were one of the students interviewed for the Mustang.
Yeah,
right?
I was on the news. A bunch of people have seen it. There's one of the people that I go to after school, separate from school class with. She's from Southampton.
Yeah.
She saw me on the news.
Yeah.
So I'm reaching all sorts of different places.
We'd be honest. Did you grab the link and just start sending it to everybody? Check me out.
That's
kind
okay.
Of.
Yeah, that's good.
That's okay.
Yeah, I would do the same thing. That's what I'm saying.
Mr. Daly, I printed out pictures of myself and autographed them for the students.
Oh, you did.
So, yeah.
Can mine's hanging on my fridge.
You were interviewed too. That's right. Yeah. Yeah, nice. Autograph?
Yeah, his autograph is on the fridge.
Oh, that's cool.
Me, Maddie, and a couple of the other guys in our shop have it either on our locker door or at our house. And Caden, one of the seniors, had Rainey autograph the dash of his car.
Oh,
so you can
true celebrity here, Mr. Rainey. Nice.
Yeah. I'd like to make a confession. You know, the kit car, I learned about this last year.
Oh, yeah.
We didn't really explain the kit car until it got... I thought it was from Knight Rider. Oh, I thought you had a Knight Rider car. And so that's what I thought the kit car was until you guys came on the show.
And it talks to you.
Yeah. Yes. But now I've learned.
Didn't
that
you have a crush? Did you have a crush on David Hasselhoff
not
for
at all.
A long time?
Not at all. No.
My
first crush did drive a Trans Am, though.
Okay.
And now I'm married to him.
cute. Listen, guys, thanks for coming on the show. Don't forget May 18th, car show 10 to 2. Everybody's going to be there. You got to go. You got to go. Mr. Rainey, I don't know if this will be the last time you've been on the radio show, but officially we want to thank you for all your years of service, right? You have definitely been an addition to the school. You picked up the shop when it was in somewhat of a transitional phase and straightened it out. We have a tremendous amount. You've done a great job of co-op, getting kids out to work, cleaning up the shop, turning out unbelievable kids out of there. You were a huge part of that, so we appreciate you.
Thank you.
We are more than going to miss you next year. But we wish you all the luck down south. And if you're ever back up in the hood, you got to stop
by.
I'll
swing by.
Yeah. All right. We're going to check out the show and the car show on the 18th, and we'll be back with a little more Tiger Talk.
Ladies up in here tonight. No fighting.
We got the refugees.
No fighting. No fighting. Shakira, Shakira.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. Hey. She make a man want to speak Spanish. Como se llama?
Sí.
Bonita.
Sí.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. Don't you see, baby, this is perfection.
Hey, girl, I can see your body moving, and it's driving me crazy. And I didn't have the slightest idea until I saw you dancing. And when you walk up on the dance floor, nobody can not ignore.
perfect. Babe, I know I'm on tonight. My hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. Don't you see, baby, Shakira, this is perfection. Shakira. Oh, boy, I can see your body moving. Half animal, half man. I don't really know what I'm doing. Just seem to have a plan. My will, I'm self-restrained. Have come to fail now, fail now. See, I'm doing what I can, but I can't. So you know that's a bit too hard to explain.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
And we are back to Tiger Talk Live. It's 8:50, almost 8:50 a.m. on Thursday the 9th. Welcome back to Tiger Talk. If you haven't been listening, now you are, right? We just had a great, great segment there with the Auto Tech guys and talking about Motorsports Club. Mr. Rainey, of course, on his last hiatus here. Mm-hmm. It's a little sad, actually.
It is.
We've seen him
come
in as a
so great to work with.
Newbie teacher, learning the ropes back in the day. I think he's been here six. I didn't ask how many years he's been here.
I think he's been here as long as I have, so at least 7 years.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Those have been a long 7 years with you, let me tell you. But
the feeling
not
is
with him.
Mutual.
Not with him. He's done a great job. He's really taken that shop to a new level. The Mustang donation, he was hard behind that, getting that donated. And we appreciate all his efforts. We're going to miss him. And we'll have to do something nice for him.
I think so.
But that was great. So the Motorsports is doing a car show, so make sure you check that out May 18th at Grandmother's Garden,
yes.
Chauncey Allen Park,
right.
10 to 2. And we had horticulture on with the plant sale, which is still going on, correct, right?
Yep, today and tomorrow.
Today and tomorrow.
Until 2. Yep.
And, of course, our restaurant is open as well.
Both
again,
days.
Again, 10:45 to 12:15. And speaking of restaurants, great segue, Mr. Daly. Thank you.
Except can I just cut your segue and make you irritated because I already
let
told
me hit the
you
cough
that
button to
I wanted
you
to thank Mrs.
Well, you
Wingate.
Could have done that any time.
No, because I can't break in with you at all.
Yeah, but the segue
thank
means
you, Mrs.
I'm going to go to the next story. Like,
yeah,
right
I know
now.
What it is. And
you're like, I have something important to say, so I am going to talk.
Thank you, Mrs. Wingate, for the song she sent us over, Daydream Believer. And then Sophia picked Shakira. Thank you. Segway. Speaking of the restaurant, Mr. Forney.
Speaking of the monkeys.
Yeah.
Waiting, Mrs. Oh, you're done now. You got your input.
He went
into
the microphone. So, if you were watching,
we have our radio and communication people on to discuss what has been going on with your shop, Mr. Forney. Really exciting news. You guys did a great job with the Mustang segment. I know you guys were there covering that. What's been hot and heavy over in radio and communications?
So the smaller thing is that today we're going to go to Western Mass News, which is exciting. So our sophomores will go and tour the studios, which we try to go at least once a year with every group. So once we're off the air, we're going to head over there. But 2 weeks ago, Chef Showdown, the third annual, right inside Tiger's Pride Restaurant, competition amongst the culinary students. And we were all hands on deck. We had photographers, camera people, voiceover. Gabby was hosted around, as you can see there. But the entire there's Jake.
Yep.
So the entire shop's involved, and it's a lot of stress, but it's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So if you don't know, this is year three.
Yes.
Three. And you've been here 3 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Mr. Forney was started it up with some input from the kids and everything. A Chef Showdown, where the group of students, and we'll have them on for sure, compete against each other, and we had outside judges come in from, I'm not sure where they were.
All over the place. Yeah. We had Westfield State Dining, MGM. We had Monica from Shortstop. That's Kai took that photo, which I think
nice
is just
Kai.
Absolutely stunning.
Yeah.
And that one, too.
Well, that is
very nice.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
An Autumnist Farm to Table was one of our sponsors. Yep. They provided a lot of the meat for us that we used. So, it was great.
Why don't we, Jake, do you have the intro clip to show what's about to come? We'll play that, and then we'll talk to the kids a little bit about what they did during the show. Well, while we're waiting for sound, I mean, you can watch the video. We might have.
Was Owen McIsaac, sophomore, who put that all together.
Yeah. So. It looks good. Yeah, apparently everything was all set, so you can check that out. We're going to keep pumping that up on Facebook, the preview.
Yeah, we'll put that up. I assume I have five people editing three episodes. Mm-hmm. They're working really hard. I don't know if it'll get done. Again, we're on a field trip, so it'll take some time away. Hopefully by the end of their next shop week, we'll have at least one episode ready to go.
Who do we have with us today, Mr. Forney?
Kai Skorupski's here, who had her hand in a variety of things, mm-hmm. Mostly photography. And Mars, who we call our kitchen director. So she was bossing around the culinary students, bossing around the photographers, bossing around pretty much everybody, bossing me around.
All right, Mars, we'll start with the boss here. Tell us what were your main responsibilities during the Chef Showdown, and what were, you know, how did you like it?
Honestly, I did a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
I like to say I was running around like a headless chicken, because I kind of was. I was, for the second day, we had a bunch of teams, so we had timers for each team, so I had to run each team's timer, and then I had to run the intermittent timer for when they could start and the next team could start, and then we had to run when they went out to the judges. I was communicating with the camera people in the kitchen along with the photographers. I was telling the teams their time. I was telling the judges when the teams will be out. Kind of just, I was a little bit of the messenger, but also telling people what to do.
So is this like a producer kind of? I mean,
basically.
Okay. So that was cool. And Kai, some of the things you did?
So I mainly did photography, but I also filmed the interviewer. I was following Gabby around on the second day as she was just interviewing a ton of the culinary students.
I can imagine, Mr. Forney, this is an unbelievable experience to get real hands-on. This is what it's like on a TV show. Everybody's running around with their head cut off, basically, right?
Yep.
In their own way, whatever their responsibility is. I know we had a table of sound people, correct?
Yes.
TV people? And what did they do?
So basically, and it's actually Mr. Coles, he has a what we call the rack, and you can, it's basically what Jake is looking at right now, and there, where it's a mobile rack where you can plug whatever, 10 different cameras into it, and then, you know, you have your main screen, and then you have a whole bunch of other little tiny screens, and so Sam was on headset with the camera people saying, ready, camera one, go one. And then he'd click it and camera one would pop up.
Right.
Ready, six, go six. And camera six pops up.
Right.
So, and then we had two cameras that were run by remotes that can go 360. So I had two students basically on Atari joysticks.
Nice.
Moving those cameras around. Ben was our audio video guy. So Ben was flying around making sure the mics worked and cables were run properly. And so everybody had their own sort of thing. And you talk about real world. I mean, it's stressful. You get to day three of shooting, you're exhausted. You're staring at food that you can't eat.
Right.
You know, it's about as real as it gets.
I thought the one word I thought about for this whole thing was stress. You know, Kai, were you feeling stressed at times when you're doing it?
Running around the kitchen.
Yeah.
Try not to bump into culinary
right.
students.
Yeah. Definitely. How were the students, no names, please, but how were the culinary students with the cameras in their face, and were they open and responsive to you? Did you have to prod these guys to talk a little bit? Like, what was the process?
Honestly, it varies year to year.
Mm-hmm.
This year was, at first, a lot of them were quite hesitant, but once they started doing it, they realized how fun it was. They realized it wasn't just, like, reality TV where it's like we're filming their worst moments ever. Mm-hmm. And they were more open to it, and they had more fun. Last year, a lot of the people were a lot more vocal, but this year there was a lot more fun, I feel. It was a little less stressful this year for a lot of students. And I communicated, I was kind of a middle ground between camera people and the team, so they would tell me if they wanted the camera people to back off or if the camera people were okay, and we just kind of went back and forth. The show, like you mentioned, is always stressful, but the best option is usually to plan for the worst but hope for the best. I always tell everyone to act like everything's going to suddenly go wrong in the morning. That way, when it does, you're calm and cool, and you're going to be able to fix it.
Nice words to live by right there, for sure. Kai, favorite part of doing Chef Showdown?
Honestly, my favorite part was taking photos.
Mm-hmm.
The food that they presented was absolutely gorgeous. Mm-hmm. And just being able to capture that was incredible.
Well, you did a great job. We saw a couple pictures up there that were fantastic. And it's not uncommon to see Kyra around the school taking pictures all the time. Is that your bag? Is that your thing? Is that what you like to do the most?
I love photography.
Yeah, yeah. Mr. Forney, after 3 years of this, obviously you can see these two are more comfortable doing it, right? They've been around it now.
Well, Kai's a sophomore. Which is interesting.
Kai's right. First I see you. Year. She's always, yeah.
And, you know, and I think to what Mars was saying about the personalities, it was a very sophomore-heavy group of culinary students. Yeah. So a lot of them have never done it before. A lot of them had no interest in doing it. And it was, and this happens every year, but this year more than most, they're like, I don't want any part of this. And Chef Rogers had to kind of talk them into it.
Yeah.
And the ones who wanted to do it the least, to me, seem to have the most fun.
Yeah.
And will be a big part next year. So I always say the show is only as good as the culinary students allow it to be. If right. they say, I don't want to do this, and they just don't take it seriously, we don't have a good product. But again, as soon as we started, they were all in. I mean, their dishes were great. They put time, effort. They did their homework. They were going home watching YouTube videos. Yeah. We were throwing secret ingredients at them, and they were crushing it.
I think
so
one of the winning entree was on yesterday at Tiger's Pride for lunch.
Yeah.
Yep.
It was.
Yeah.
Definitely, most of the teams I talked to, most of the sophomores afterwards, they want to do it next year again. Yeah. They had a good time. So we have that to look forward to.
Yeah. I think overall for the whole school, it's a great experience. We always look forward to the shows when they're finished and edited. How many hours of what was it called, B-roll?
Yeah, footage, just footage in general, yeah.
How much footage and B-roll do you
have? We have about 10 and a half hours.
And you're going to narrow that down to what?
Probably 3 20 to 25 minute episodes. Yeah.
So there's a lot of stuff that ends up cut on the floor and the kids never see. But it's a great collaboration between both shops. It's we have a lot of that collaboration behind the scenes that people don't even talk about all the time. But a great experience for the culinary kids to work under that kind of pressure, because you know, in the restaurant industry, the key is to get food out, get it done, get it right, and make sure it's good. And obviously for you guys, so many things to do and to benefit from by doing a little mini show like that as well.
We did a lot of behind the scenes stuff too, so we'll probably have a graphics behind the scenes video as well. But you know, I tell these culinary kids, I'm like, look, when you graduate and you want to get some job at a high-end restaurant in New York City, guess who can put together a highlight reel for you?
Yeah.
Like, we have highlights of you as a sophomore crushing it in the kitchen.
It's an untapped resource that we haven't even broached yet, you know, but it's awesome. You guys did a great job. We're looking forward to the final three episodes, which ballpark?
I'd say episode one probably by their next shop week, which is 2 weeks away. Okay. And then I'd like to release them 1 week at a time just to build.
And those will be out. You can check them out on our Facebook page.
Yep, and the Westfield Community Programming YouTube page. Perfect. And our Facebook page.
Well, have great at the field trip today, guys.
I'm not going.
You're not going? Are you going?
Yes.
Okay. Have fun at the field trip today. It's a great time. Mr. Forney, thanks for coming on.
My pleasure.
All right. That's it, Mrs. Groom.
Have a great week.
Another hour done, and Tiger Talk is over. Hopefully we'll see you next week.
Sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.